Maybe it's 3 a.m. had you on my mind. It's the first time we've gone through this.
Alright, so guys, before the video starts, I do want to say we are doing a Xbox giveaway for Xbox players only, where you can get a Mag Prime or 100 Platinum. So make sure you do put your Xbox gaming tag in the comment section down below and drop a like and subscribe to the channel for an extra chance. I'll be picking out the winners at the end of the month, and yeah, good luck to you guys. What is up, guys? It is me, KOV. Now, in today's video, we are doing a Hildryn build. Now, Hildryn is a really good frame to play. Now that the shield thing that came out quite a while ago, Hildryn is now a really good frame to play, and she's a really good tank. Now, I've been playing her recently just because I've been getting bored of other frames, and I've been trying out new ones, and Hildryn is actually really not bad. She can clear out low level enemies, so like the old Ember, how old Ember used to be able to just clear out old, low level enemies quite easily. Hildryn can now do that, and mainly she gives a lot of shield, and she can give status effects away. So let's get into her abilities. So now first is a Balefire. Now personally I don't really use this much, but basically you charge and launch devastating bolts of fire. Now I don't really use this a lot because this is mainly for DPS, and I've got other stuff that I use for DPS. So next is a Pillage. Pillage a percentage of shields and armor of nearby enemies to replenish Hildryn's own shield and overshields. Also removes status effects from Hildryn and her allies. Now this is really good. So let's say if you're doing like high end survivals or something, what personally I wouldn't do with Hildryn, but say you are with Hildryn, you can get rid of them status effects. So toxin status effects can be really dangerous on high level survivals. And also giving you shield as well is also a really good benefit now, because now you can't get just like one shot. You have to take your shield, then you're invulnerable for like a second. So next is Haven. Now this creates a shield aura around enemies that approach shielded allies will take damage. Now this is what I mean by being able to take out low level enemies. It don't do super amounts of damage, but it still does a decent amount to take out low levels. So next is Aegis Storm. Now this is basically a crowd control ability. So you take the skies and rain Balefire rockets down on the enemy. Nearby enemies are blasted into the air, where they will create an energy orb every few seconds when shields run out. The enemies are smashed into the ground. So now what this does is basically you'll go into the air like this, and you see the aura around me, that is where they will get affected, and this will drain your shield. Now the higher you go, the smaller the shield comes, but the more damage you do. So if you see here, it's got a lot more smaller. Now this will drain your shield, but it is fine because literally you can get your shield back really quick. So if I just unpause these real quick, and I'm going to show you on how everything will work. So what I'll do is I'll first pop my Pillage. Now this will do all this to him. I'll then pop my third. We'll then do small amounts of damage to him, but then we can keep getting our shield back, or we can crowd control him like this, and there we go, we got our shield straight back up. Now this also drops energy orbs like I said earlier, so this really helps your team out if they are, for example, a DPS or something like that. So now I normally just go like that just because I need to go like that real quick. You see here, back up to 5,000 shield in no time. Now you just keep doing this over and over, and then you can crowd control them, and your team, because you're mainly not really going to be a DPS if you're playing Hildryn, you're mainly just going to be a support, and you keep doing this to get your overshield back. So you use your Pillage, and then you'll use your ultimate, what is Aegis Storm, to get some of your shield back. So you just keep doing this, Pillage, shield in Aegis, and back up to 5,000 shield. Now this is a really good thing to do, especially in high-end survivals. How you see here, these are all level 90s, and they'll take down my shield down, but I'm back up to 5,000 in a matter of seconds. Now this is why she is very good using Hildryn, because this can help out in survivals definitely, and if you're playing as a team, this can really help out if you have a Hildryn that knows what she's doing, and it can keep getting your shield back up, and also making you so you're not taking them status effects. So really recommend having a hildryn. So you see here, I'm not doing tons of damage, but it's mainly just for crowd control. You want to mainly be using hildryn for the crowd control. Like again, you want to use your pillage, use this, and then your shield will go up slightly. Now yes, the shield will eventually go down, but if you keep doing this strategy, it shouldn't take too long for your shield to all come back. So I do recommend bringing a decent DPS weapon, as hildryn doesn't do a lot of DPS. So let's get into the build that I am using. So the build that I am using is kind of a simple build, to be honest. I'm pretty sure I've got a zero reformer on my hildryn, but we have enemy radar, redirection, because obviously we want to have the maximum amount of shield. We've got overextended for the range, blind rage, so damage isn't lower than 100%, because we don't want it to be that low. We have steel fiber for the armor. We have vigor, mainly just for the shield, but obviously the extra health is nice. Stretch, streamline, and auger reach. Now, mainly this is just mainly a range build. You could build more of a better build if you add form into this. For example, you could add, like, say, for example, umbral intensify and umbral fiber to increase your tankiness and your damage a bit. So that's a really good thing that you could do. Now, the arcanes that I use is arcane fury and arcane guardian. Mainly arcane guardian, just obviously so I can get more armor, what is definitely nice. Now, the level that I've got mine is 603, what will give us 600 armor. So that'll put us at 1,200 armor. And also arcane fury, because obviously I just always use melee all the time. And because arcane fury has a 50% chance for 150% melee damage on crit hit. And if you use melee right, you're mainly going to be critting all the time. For example, this Pangolian, 91% crit chance, I'm going to be critting all the time. So yeah, that's been the hildryn video. I hope you guys did enjoy this video. Make sure you drop a like and subscribe, I very much appreciate it. And yeah, see you guys later.